We started with just testing 1,000 students per day during move-in, and then we were able to scale to 12,000, and then now we test about 20,000 students per week. So fortunately, we have a lot of smart people here on campus, and we were able to really use a constant flow model where our students schedule in 15-minute time blocks, so they're able to come in. We have a great flow going through, but we did realize as we started to scale, that's when additional kind of bottleneck and issues could come up. So we were able to reach out to some of our friends here on campus that are the experts, and they were really able to help us think through what does the large scale 20,000 actually look like here in our testing site.
When the Ohio State University reopened campus to students and some faculty and staff during the COVID-19 pandemic this fall, it was clear that regular testing of asymptomatic members of campus would need to be a key part of opening safely. The university contracted with an outside vendor to manage those tests, but the day-to-day logistics fell to university staff. Christy Bertolo, who is part of Ohio State's COVID-19 implementation team, knew that in order to get more students, faculty, and staff tested, the university needed to find a way to manage those logistics. So she called Sean Midlam Moeller, director of Ohio State's Simulation, Innovation, and Modeling Center.
So they were interested in seeing if we could use modeling and simulation to help predict what was going to happen when they started ramping up testing. They already had maps, and they'd done some preliminary calculations of kind of what the setup was. And I was just able to observe what was happening at the testing center. And I basically got out my iPad stopwatch and was, you know, tallying, you know, how long it took certain steps.
The simulations, Midlam Moeller realized, were not much different from the models and simulations he ran for factories and assembly lines.
As you're trying to process a large number of people in a small amount of time in a very controlled way, so using the same types of things one would use for that type of modeling, we're able to develop a model of people moving through a COVID testing center.
The outside contractor had been taking Ohio State's tests to New Jersey for diagnostics. But this week, the university opened its own lab to run those tests. Now, results from COVID-19 tests should be available more quickly. On-campus diagnostics will also save the university millions of dollars. For Ohio State News, I'm Laura Ehrenschild.